So I welcome you all for this breath mastery session, guys. Immense gratitude to each one of you for joining this session. I really appreciate you could have been doing anything, office work or any work at this point of time, and you took out your time to attend this breathing session. And it shows that you are here for some reason to learn. And yes, I would certainly like to like that whatever you learn, you start implementing. In fact, teach your kids and your family also in this crazy pandemic situation. So today, we'll be doing something. First of all, are you all sure that you are breathing right? If you're breathing right, you can raise your right hand, guys. Or if you cannot open your, screen, basically, if you cannot keep your video on, you can just message me here in chat box. Are you breathing right, guys? Can I have some hand raises or not? Thank you, Priyanka. Thank you, Kartika. And thank you, Madhav. Very nice. Prabhakar, good. Zubair, good. Thank you. Thank you so much. That's good. Thank you so much for your replies. Thank you, Shalini. How many of you think that you are struggling with your breath and not breathing, right? So you can raise your both hands or just message here in comment box, SB, struggling with breath. Struggling with breath. You can raise your both hands. That's completely fine. And I would be honest, guys, that's it. There's nothing like that. So maybe a little bit I will tell about whether you are breathing right or wrong. You can quickly check. So three things I'll be sharing with you. First, whether you are a mouth breather or you are a chest breather or you are a belly breather. So we can have this identification of breathing pattern. Before we go further, is it okay if I tell you about quickly about my background, guys? Is it okay? If it is okay, just message here, okay? With all due permission of yours. Thank you, Madhav. Thank you so much. Thank you, Priyanka. Thank you. So I'm Yukti Raj Kishore. I'm breathing fitness expert, Nirvana fitness ambassador, as well as I'm a certified flow coach, yoga instructor too. And I take sessions for adults as well as for kids for yoga and Nirvana fitness flow. And I take corporate workshops also. There was a point in my life where I have been through, I was a working mother and in a corporate world and with a lot of issues, with health issues, mental, physical, I was able to overcome all those issues when I came across this breathing fitness, and that has actually accelerated my fitness journey. I was able to do things that I never thought before, even in my some few years back, because I have been through a lot of ups and downs in my life. And from there, it became my mission to help people to connect to the power of their breath, unleash the potential of their own breath, discover the power of their breath, attain mental peace, overcome stress and anxiety, and spread this breath awareness to their families and societies. So that was a small brief introduction. You can always connect to me. I'll share my links also. Yoga with Yuktiness is my YouTube channel. And rest all links also I'll share so that you can always connect to me. So let's go further. So what we are going to do is, first is identification of our breathing pattern. So first thing is, just see if you are climbing few stairs and if you feel, not able to breathe, right? If you are snoring at nighttime more often, or a little bit of walking on steep places, if you walk upside, you feel very breathless. You feel that breathlessness is building up. Even I would say that little bit of fast walking is also, you start huffing and puffing very often. And you have to observe, are you a mouth breather? That is, most of the time you're breathing through your mouth. But that means this is your breathing pattern. That is, you are a mouth breather. Second is chest breathing. So I want everyone to sit nicely on a chair. If you are sitting on a chair, that's completely fine. Keep one hand. So right palm over your belly. I'll go back on my mat so that you can see me. You can keep one palm over your belly, another palm over your chest. So why I'm telling you this? Why I'm telling you this is because wherever I go, whatever I do, I start with the basics first, because that is very important. More than learning any breathing technique and applying that, first of all, what is important is you know your breathing pattern. Once you know your breathing pattern, then only you can scale it up. Am I right, guys? If I'm right, message me here in chat box, right, please. So that I can see you are there with me and you are actually very much in present moment. Thank you, Madhav. Okay, thank you, Neha. Yeah. Thank you. So keep your right palm over your belly, another hand over your chest. You can keep your eyes open or closed, that doesn't matter. Here, just breathe. Normal breath, no deep breath. Just breathe. Because after that, I'm going to ask you a lot of questions. So be ready. I want you to observe what is happening when you are breathing. When you are inhaling, how your right hand, that is your belly hand, is moving. When you are exhaling, how your left hand or your chest hand is moving, basically how your both hands are moving when you are inhaling and exhaling. Normal breath, no deep breath. Okay, now message me here. When you are inhaling, what is happening? Is your chest moving up and down like this? Hope you can see me. If you have kept your videos on, I would have checked. So your chest is moving up and down. Is it something that you are facing? If yes, then message me here how you are breathing. When you are inhaling, what is happening, guys? Whether your belly hand is going up and down or out or in. May I know some answers, please? Quickly. Shani, Zubair, Rachel, everyone please message me here how you are breathing. Come on. Prabhakar, unable to identify. Okay. So just tell me when you are breathing in, which hand is going up, down or coming out or in? Anything that you are able to observe? Okay, no worries. So I'll only tell you, right hand, yes, both. Okay. Okay, Kunal, while inhaling, chest hand goes up. So you are inhaling like this. Ramya, right hand while inhaling. Right hand is on your belly, right? So I tell you what happens. So if you are inhaling and your chest is going up, you feel that your chest is going up. Vertically up and your belly is going in. If something you are doing, that means you are using more of your chest engagement while you are breathing and you are more of a chest breather rather than a belly breather. So you are engaging more your upper lungs rather than your lower lungs. You are not utilizing your full lung capacity. Whereas in normal situations, inhale. And if your right hand, that is your belly hand is going out. And as you exhale, belly hand goes in and you breathe out through your nose. Okay. Inhale and exhale. So that means you are a belly breather. While you are inhaling, your belly is going out. And while exhaling, it's swelling. Yeah, that's correct, Kunal. Yeah, so your belly is going out, little bit of swelling, you can say, yeah, belly goes out. So there's an expansion in your belly when you are inhaling and there's a contraction in your belly when you are exhaling. So a lot of people are actually breathing wrong. In fact, science has reported that 80% of the population is breathing wrong. They are using more of your chest. It could be possible that at some point of time, usually when people sleep, they are a belly breather. But in regular affairs, right, at that point of time, yes, Zubair, I'll tell you. At that point of a time in regular affairs, you may find yourself breathing with your chest. While working out and all, if you're breathing, while running and all, it is still okay. Because you need a supply of air very quickly and then you start chest breathing. So are you really excited to know what is the right way of breathing, guys? Really excited to know how what is the right and natural way of breathing? Okay, thank you, Ankita. Thank you, Abhishek, Neha, Zubair. Thank you. Okay, so the right way of breathing is, okay, I'm going to share my screen for sure for this particular thing. Let me just quickly share. So now you'll be surprised when you come across this very fact that what is the right way of breathing. You know why, everyone? Because this is the way we are born to breathe. And how we are born to breathe? Breathe like a baby. Yes, you are hearing me, right? Breathe like a baby. Now, how does babies breathe? Have you ever noticed that? How does babies breathe? Have you noticed? They breathe in and their belly goes up. They breathe out, their belly goes down. They breathe in, belly goes up. They breathe out, belly goes down. If you see infants, how do they breathe? Breathe in, belly goes up. Breathe out, belly goes down. So this is a, you know, the natural way of breathing, the belly breathing or diaphragmatic breathing, you can say, because we are using our diaphragm to breathe. Okay. So diaphragm is our primary breathing muscle that most of us are even not aware of. Here, and how where it is, so when we breathe in, what happens? We breathe in, our lungs expand, our diaphragm goes down, belly expands. When we breathe out, belly goes in, diaphragm goes up, lungs contract, and we breathe out to our nose. Is it clear to everyone? If it is clear, this message here is clear, so that we will quickly move on. Clear to everyone? Thank you, Krinal. Thank you, Iman. Thank you, Kartika. Awesome audience. Okay, so you can see here a quick I'm sharing with you that when you are inhaling, belly is going out. When you are exhaling, belly is going in. This is a very, very, you know, the naturally how the kids are born to breathe, how we first, our first breathing pattern is this. Okay, now I'll share one small video so that you will get very much clarity about it, how you can, you know, how actually it works. It's a very, very beautiful video. Yeah.
Your lungs expand to bring in life's essential gas, oxygen, from the air. Expanded lungs naturally contract to expel the body's waste gas, carbon dioxide. Your lungs usually expand and contract in two main ways. One is an unconscious downward and upward movement of a thin muscle called the diaphragm, which separates the chest from the belly. The other way is by raising or lowering the ribs to increase or decrease the volume of the chest cavity. We breathe in or inhale when the diaphragm contracts. This pulls the lower part of the lungs downward. When we breathe out or exhale, the diaphragm and lungs relax and return to their resting positions. Quiet, deep belly breathing is a more consciously controlled breathing that, with practice, can become the standard way you breathe. Deep belly breathing aids the diaphragm muscle movement by expanding and contracting the abdomen, the area below the diaphragm. This allows the belly muscles to push stomach and diaphragm up, which forces out more carbon dioxide waste.
Okay, so I hope everyone has got it and it is very, very clear to everyone. If you understand it, just message me here clear so that we can move ahead to the practical part of it. So far, so good. Are we good? If we are good, then just message here good. Everyone message me here good. Nice. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you so much, guys, for sharing your energies. You're not sharing just the chat message with me. You're sharing your energies with me. Thank you so much. Okay, so today we'll have a quick session so you can all sit and chair also, hardly matters. You can just interlock your fingers nicely, stretch up. Take a deep breath in and stretch up and breathe out. Bring it forward. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in through your nose. Feel the expansion in your belly area and exhale, breathe out. Release. Okay. Stretch your arm nicely. Breathe in. Stretch your fingers also. Okay. Yeah. And exhale. Keep doing inhale and exhale and just move your fingers nicely. Okay. Join your palms nicely. Join your palms. Stretch in front of you. Inhale. Open up your arms. Exhale. Allow your shoulder muscles to move. Inhale. Open up your chest. Exhale. Two. Inhale. And exhale. Three. Inhale. And exhale. Four. Inhale. And exhale. Five. Release your hands nicely. Okay. Yeah. So now you can just hold the opposite armrest of your chair if you're sitting on the chair, or just twist sideways, stretch your arms nicely up and bend. As you exhale, come to the center one more time. Inhale at the center, everyone. And exhale, bend sideways. Inhale at the center. Exhale, bend sideways. Inhale at the center and bring your hands down. Cross it. Left arm up nicely. Stretch your chest. Lift your chest up nicely. Inhale, chest up. Exhale, side bend. Inhale up. Exhale, side bend. Inhale up. Exhale, side bend. Come to the center. In fact, you can hold your armrest and look back also. Twist, pull, and twist. So these spinal twists are really, really, very good if you're working all the time on your chair. Come to the center, and we can twist nicely. Other side. Again, come to the center. Inhale, exhale, twist. Inhale, center. Exhale, twist, come to the center. And let's start our first breathing practice. So today I'll be sharing with you one breathing practice that is called pursed lip breathing. Why I'm sharing you this particular breathing technique, because most of you might not be even knowing this breathing technique. We know a lot of pranayams here in India. And so this is a very, very beautiful technique. It has it's the first breathing technique that I have learned, and it has really benefited me a lot. It helps you to work on your lung capacity. It builds your lungs stronger. How and what is the science behind it, I'll explain you. In this breathing technique, you'll be inhaling through your nose, everyone. Okay, you will inhale through your nose. Exhale through your mouth, first thing. And how you are exhaling, that is very, very important. You will be exhaling as if there is a straw in your mouth. So the opening of your lips will be very, very small. As if you have a straw. So if you have a pen or something, you can actually put, if you could have, keep your videos on, I would have really loved to watch and correct you also. But try making a very small hole from your lips. Your lips are pursed lips. Okay. So how you are inhaling? Through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Okay. Always remember that. Inhaling through your nose. Everyone do this with me. Exhale through your mouth. This is first thing. When we will inhale, our belly will go out. That is, you are expanding your belly nicely. Exhale, belly will go in. No chest movement up and down. So it is like 360 degree expansion of your chest and belly as you inhale. Your ribcage expanded, 360 degree, your belly expands. Exhale, the whole system will contract and you will be doing narrowed pursed lip exhalation. Why it is a narrowed and, why we are narrowing the exhalation? We are narrowing the exhalation because we are training our lungs to retain air for longer duration, okay? So that the lung will reach to the lower lung, not only from the upper lung, but we use the lower lung capacity also. And a lot of stale air is there in the end of our lungs. So that starts moving so that you start supplying fresh air to your lungs, as well as when you are supplying fresh air to your lungs, it will be then supplied to your cells also. Is that clear? Am I clear to everyone? Are we good? Are you with me? Just message here with me, with you. If this PLB is clear to all of you, thank you, Madhav. Thank you so much. Thank you, Zubair. Thank you, Hemant. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Stephen. Thank you, Samita, Akansha. Great. Great, great. All of you are so superb, guys. Thank you. So, yes. So, this is a Nirvana Fitness technique. So, we will be doing with first, I'll make you practice with the bowl and then we can do it with the music also. So let me just show you one time so that you will get how you are going to do this is you will keep your right palm over your belly. Just simply right palm over your belly, another hand near your mouth, not very far off, not very close. It's like, you know, just one finger kind of, okay? So that when you inhale, your belly goes out. When you exhale, you are doing a first lip narrowed exhalation and you will feel warm, moist air at the center of your palm. So your exhalation is very, very narrowed and you will actually feel warm, moist air. If you are doing something like this, look at me. We are not blowing candles here, like big thing. Hope you understand. Okay, it is a very, very narrowed exhalation that we are doing. So let's go ahead. Four breathing patterns we'll do today. First, let's 4 count inhale, 4 count exhale. Let me prepare you all. So first rule of breathing practice is make sure you're sitting nicely on your sit bone. You can always move yourself left and right, guys. Observe your sit bone. See, are you sitting properly? That means your weight is on both of your sit bones or not. Okay, first thing. Second, just see that your spine is aligned or not. Spine, very, very important. Your spine is aligned or not. Second thing, stretch your arms nicely in front of you, nicely, as if you are going to open the window and drop your hands nicely. You can feel now your shoulders are back. Keep your palms over your thighs. That's it. Now, one hand over your belly, another hand, left hand near your mouth, and let's start. Breathe in, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. In through your nose, out through your mouth. In, 2, 3, 4. Exhale through your mouth, first lip. Inhale, belly expanded. Exhale, navel in. In, 2, 3, 4. Out, 2, 3, 4. In, 2, 3, 4. Out, 2, 3, 4. Inhale, fill your belly with air. Nicely expand. Exhale, squeeze your belly, breathing out through your mouth. First lift. In. Out. And relax, everyone. Resume your normal breathing. So let's practice this breathing with the music, Nirvana music. All of you are ready, excited? If you are ready and excited with Nirvana breathing, just message me here, ND. So now I'm taking it to the next level. That is, we will be doing 4-8 breathing patterns, 4 count inhale and 8 count exhale. And then we'll be doing 4-12 breathing pattern also. So listen to this music. And along with the music, we'll do this breath activation. And I'll be keep guiding you also. Enjoy the music and let's practice some more breathing. Okay, so take position, keep your right palm over your belly, another hand near your mouth. Breathing pattern. In. Out. In. Out. 2, 3, 4. In. 2, 3, 4. Out. 2, 3. Inhale through your nose. Belly expanded. Exhale. Breathing now. Pulse lift. 8, 2, 3, out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, in, out, in, out. Normal breath. Keep your eyes closed. Feel and observe your breath. Take a deep breath in and breathe out through your nose only now. Inhale through your nose and exhale through your nose. Inhale and exhale. In and out. As you inhale, feel your whole body, you are filling with a lot of positive energy from the universe. And with exhale, you release all the negative emotions, toxic thoughts from your body. With inhale, you welcome all new thought patterns in your life. that supports you. With exhale, you release all old thought patterns that no longer serve you. Say to yourself, with each breath, I am breathing. I am with my breath. My breath is an anchor to keep me rooted in this very present moment, right here, right now. Observe the flow of breath, the life energy, the prana. Any thought that pops up, you can just observe and let go, bringing your attention back to your breath. Keep a gentle smile on your face. Join your palms, bow your head, and just say to yourself, I'm grateful to my breath. I'm grateful to my healthy body, mind, and soul. I'm grateful to this whole universe. You can open your eyes. Thank you all. Thank you so much.